It's March! Again and again and again. Andrew Cuomo is in some deep political trouble. Once seen as a shoo-in for a fourth term as governor of New York in 2022 and a possible presidential candidate for Democrats down the line, Cuomo is now facing a series of allegations and scandals that could very well end his political career. It's a remarkable fall and a reminder that politics is a wildly unpredictable business where one year's hero can be next year's goat. Now, there's a lot to unpack with Cuomo's problems, but let's start here. Two women who have once worked for him have accused him of sexual harassment. In late February, the New York Times reported on allegations made by a woman named Charlotte Bennett, a 25-year-old former executive assistant and health policy advisor to Cuomo. And Bennett told the Times that during one of several uncomfortable encounters, this one a conversation in his state capitol office, Cuomo asked her numerous questions about her romantic life and said he was open to relationships with women in their 20s. The Times said that Bennett regarded Cuomo's comments as, quote, clear overtures to a sexual relationship, end quote. As of this episode's taping, CNN has not heard back from Bennett after reaching out to her for comment. Quote, I acknowledge some of the things I have said have been misinterpreted as an unwanted flirtation, Cuomo said in a statement in response to Bennett's allegations, adding, quote, to the extent anyone felt that way, I am truly sorry about that, end quote. Now, the Bennett accusations came just days after a Medium post written by Lindsay Boylan, another former Cuomo aide, in which she made a number of allegations against the governor, including that in 2018, Cuomo, quote, stepped in front of me and kissed me on the lips. End quote. Cuomo's office categorically denied Boylan's accusations about the kiss. They also pushed back on another allegation in Boylan's Medium post that the governor had suggested he and Boylan play, quote, strip poker, end quote, on a flight, providing denials from four different current and former staffers who had flown with Boylan and Cuomo and insisted that episode did not happen. Now, important note, CNN has not been able to independently corroborate the allegations, and when asked for further comment, Boylan, who is currently running for Manhattan Borough President, replied that she was letting her Medium post speak for itself. Sidebar. Boylan first made the allegation of sexual harassment in December 2020. Cuomo denied it at that time as well. Meanwhile, Cuomo has called for an independent review of all of the accusations against him to be selected by State Attorney General Letitia James and the top judge in New York State. But James rejected that proposal, suggesting that it could be seen as Cuomo trying to exert some control over the investigation. And instead, her office has requested an official referral that would provide the investigation, which will be handled by an outside law firm, with subpoena power. Now, the allegations made by Boylan and Bennett are far from the only problems that Andrew Cuomo is now confronted with. For several months now, Cuomo has found himself on the defensive over his administration's handling of the reporting of deaths of nursing home residents from COVID-19 in New York State. So in February, a Cuomo aide named Melissa DeRosa apologized to New York Democratic lawmakers, saying the administration, quote unquote, froze out of concerns over a federal investigation when initially asked by state legislators way back in August 2020 about the nursing home issue. DeRosa later sought to clarify remarks, saying this, quote, I was explaining that when we received the Department of Justice inquiry, we needed to temporarily set aside the legislature's request to deal with the federal request first. We informed the houses of this at the time. We were comprehensive and transparent in our responses to the DOJ and then had to immediately focus our resources on the second wave and vaccine rollout. As I said on a call with legislators, we could not fulfill their request as quickly as anyone would have liked. Now, Cuomo has since said that the misunderstanding of why he would put a pause on providing the data on nursing home resident deaths to state lawmakers, he says he did so because of requests for the data from the Department of Justice were prioritized, was the result of an information vacuum that led to quote-unquote misinformation and quote-unquote lying from other politicians and the media. Here's Cuomo.
I did not aggressively enough, we did not aggressively enough take on the misinformation that caused people pain. And it caused pain for grieving families. And that's what I regret. I'm not going to make that mistake again.
Now, according to the New York Department of Health, people who lived in long-term care facilities make up more than 15,000 confirmed and presumed COVID-19 deaths in New York since the start of the coronavirus pandemic. And a report released in January by Letitia James, the New York Attorney General, who again is a Democrat, suggested that Cuomo's administration undercounted deaths among nursing home residents by as much as 50%. Quote, Preliminary data obtained by the Office of the Attorney General suggests that many nursing home residents died from COVID-19 in hospitals after being transferred from their nursing homes, which is not reflected in the Department of Health's published total nursing home death data, read a summary of the James report. New York Democratic Congresswoman Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez, who is one of the leading progressive voices in the country and a popular figure in New York City, weighed in on the Cuomo controversy in February, saying in a statement from her office, quote, "I stand with our local officials calling for a full investigation of the Cuomo administration's handling of nursing homes during COVID-19, end quote. So even as he was seeking to control the fallout from the nursing home controversy, Cuomo stepped in again. Democratic State Assemblyman Ron Kim said Cuomo threatened him in a phone conversation in January. Kim has become an outspoken critic of Cuomo on this issue, and as he recounted to CNN's MJ Lee and Mark Morales in a story that ran on February 17th,
quote, "Governor Cuomo called me directly on Thursday to threaten my career if I did not cover up for Melissa DeRosa and what she said. He tried to pressure me to issue a statement, and it was a very traumatizing experience." Now, he went on to say that Cuomo said, "We are in this business together and we don't cross certain lines." And he said, "I hadn't seen his wrath and that he can destroy me."
Now, Cuomo senior advisor Rich Azzopardi said in a statement to CNN that, quote, "Kim's assertion that the governor said he would destroy him is false. The governor has three witnesses to the conversation. The operable words were to the effect of, quote, I am from Queens too, and people still expect honor, integrity in politics," end quote. Now, the broader point here is this. Cuomo is now fighting multiple legal and political battles, the sort of thing that politicians hope to go an entire career without experiencing. Every state and national reporter is now digging into the various allegations against Cuomo, from the nursing homes to the bullying to his personal conduct with women who work for him. And almost no one ever completely emerges unscathed from that sort of political scrutiny. Republicans who are sensing opportunity have begun to circle Cuomo ahead of 2022. Congressman Tom Reed said he's taking a hard look at running, joining fellow congresspeople Elise Stefanik and Lee Zeldin, among many other potential Republicans in the mix. And a recent poll from Siena College did show that Cuomo's approval is slightly down. 51% of New York voters said they approved of the job he was doing, while 47% described his performance as either fair or poor. That's down from a 56% approved, 42% fair or poor score in a January Siena poll. Now, Cuomo has proven to be a resilient politician over his three terms in office, having defeated several high-profile primary challengers, including Cynthia Nixon, and putting himself on the verge of doing something his father, the late New York Governor Mario Cuomo, never did, winning four terms as governor. But this series of problems poses the most serious threat to Andrew Cuomo's political life that he has ever dealt with, and he's not even close to putting these problems behind him. And that is The Point. We make new Point episodes every Tuesday and Thursday. Check them all out.